Good afternoon and welcome. I'm David Cottiga, Chair of the Board of Trustees. On behalf of incoming Chair Chris Leslie and the entire Board of Trustees, I would like to extend our welcome to those gathered here in Norris and to our Zoom and YouTube audiences as we celebrate the retirement of Peter Bachmann, our headmaster for the past 30 years. Before we begin our virtual celebration this afternoon, let me acknowledge that like almost everything in 2020, it wasn't supposed to happen this way. For more than a year, we have been planning a community-wide, in-person retirement ceremony for Peter, with all of you present. Your presence, your energy, your love, your admiration, as well as your thanks, would have been on full display in a manner in which only the prep community could manifest. For now, however, this virtual celebration will have to suffice. Peter's role in our lives and our community could not have been more impactful or more salient. To so many of us, Peter is a friend, a mentor, a teacher, a colleague, a thinker, a leader, and perhaps most importantly, a kind and loving human being. This afternoon, we will pay tribute to Peter with our words, our videos, our songs, and a remembrance or two. But most importantly, and frankly, the reason why we have assembled here today, in Norris and out there, is to listen to Peter speak to us in his own words one more time as headmaster of prep. Before we get to Peter, I would like to introduce our first speaker via video, Katie Thompson, class of 2005. Katie was chosen by Peter to speak on behalf of students and alumni. For those who don't know, Katie recently completed her MBA at the University of Michigan, has served in independent schools in admissions, enrollment, and financial aid, and as importantly, Katie is joining the Board of Trustees this fall. Ladies and gentlemen, Katie Thompson.
Good afternoon, trustees, students, parents, my fellow alumni, faculty, staff, friends, Molly, Rob, and of course, Peter Bachmann. I am so grateful and I'm so excited to speak here today in celebration of Peter Bachmann and the community he has built here at PrEP. Of course, in the age of global pandemic, here at PrEP has taken on new meaning, and I, like most of you, am not physically here at PrEP, unfortunately. Nonetheless, the moment serves to remind us that PrEP exists not only at the crossroads of Crown and Foothill, but all over the country and all over the world. Nonetheless, it feels painfully inadequate to celebrate Peter Bachmann, the consummate community builder and architect of PrEP for Life, by recording a video on my phone some 2,000 miles away from La Cañada. After all, it's always been Mr. Bachmann, as we alums once and forever know him, who instilled in us students the joy of in-person collaboration, discussion, debate, and discovery around a table in the 50s building or conference room or alumni house. But when I started to think about what I wanted to share today, my memories took me back to a different classroom on campus. In the fall of 2004, he and I, then a high school senior, visited a seventh grade literature class to talk about the school's honor code. We shared its history, its importance to our community, and its values. Honest, kind, generous, respectful. After our short presentation, a seventh grader slowly raised his hand to ask a question. Mr. Bachmann, but of the honor code's values, which is your favorite? Now, all these years later, I can still picture this scene so very vividly and hear Peter's response so very clearly in my memory. In typical Peter Bachmann fashion, without missing a beat, he replied, "Well, that would be like having to choose a favorite child." Indeed, in this moment of celebration of Peter Bachmann, it absolutely feels like having to choose a favorite child when picking words and sharing stories to describe the impact he has had on so many generations of alums. That is to say, it is completely uncomfortable and entirely impossible to do so. But what better set of words to describe Peter than those values which we as a community have chosen to embrace for so many decades? Honest, kind, generous, respectful. But I'm sorry, Peter Bachmann, I only have a little bit of time here, so I have no other choice but to go against your wise words and pick a favorite child, so to speak. While you are all of these traits and so much more, there is one in particular which you embody and which you and your family have instilled in the soul of this school, and that is generosity. Now that I've spent most of my career working in and with independent schools, I realize just how unique the inclusion of this word generosity is, and how it sets our community apart in the most special and most important of ways. Peter's generosity of time, talent, and spirit is well documented and marks his time here. As students, we often don't think of the grinding behind-the-scenes work he has done to build a strong school, balancing academics and human development, to preserve our beautiful campus, to construct new facilities, and to preserve our alma mater's sustainability into the future. Through it all, he's taught history, great books, American Identity. He's appeared at countless dinners, plays, rehearsals, recitals, concerts, performances, matches, meets, games, JPDs, book days, proms, dances, baccalaureates, graduations, and countless alumni events, formal and informal. He served as an, I think, willing witness in mock trials. He's advised independent studies, but perhaps most importantly, he has never, ever failed to drop everything on his busy plate to help a community member in need. Molly and Rob have similarly been devoted and unfailingly generous in their support of this school. In anticipation of Peter's retirement, I recently pulled a couple of my original great books readings off my bookshelf. They've been with me since book day 2004 and have since made 4 or 5 moves across the country with me. You can tell they are original because I wrote my name on every available surface, something I later learned most adults don't generally do. I was particularly drawn to revisit Thoreau's Walden, as Peter had recently called for members of our community to seek out our own Walden moments. As I flipped through, I reacquainted myself with the copious underlining of my 17-year-old self, stars and check marks and marginal notes. I even found a few notes I'd passed back and forth to a classmate, which, I'm sorry, Peter Bachmann, I'm sure that occurred exclusively on our own time and not in class. But when I flipped to the inside of the back cover, I was reminded of a powerful memory. As time period witnesses will attest, I was a very sentimental high school senior, and thus I recorded Mr. Bachmann's final message to our class at the end of the semester. Referring to Thoreau's adage, encouraging us to advance confidently in the direction of our dreams, pursuing the life we've always imagined, on the last day of class, Mr. Bachmann left us with these words: "The life you've always imagined. I hope so." As we set out for college and for the rest of our lives, thank you, Peter Bachmann, for leaving us with your hope and encouragement to pursue the life we've each imagined, confident and secure in the knowledge that prep and the people we love there would always be there to cheer us on. Not only have you guided thousands of us through this journey of discernment to discover the person we desire to be and the life we desire to live, you have powerfully lived the good life yourself. Your teaching, as well as your example, inspire us and remind us to never lose sight of our own journey to the good life. You have always demonstrated great optimism and faith in us and in our futures. So too do we have great loyalty to the school you have built so carefully and so lovingly over so many decades. Peter Bachmann, congratulations on your well-deserved retirement on Zoom and YouTube and in Norris Auditorium. We are thrilled to be celebrating your headship, your teaching, your mentorship, your friendship, and your service to our alma mater, just as you have for so many decades generously supported us, the students of Flint Ridge Prep, in our own adolescence, adulthood, and journey to the good life. Thank you. We love you. Congratulations.
To engage fathers in the Flint Ridge Prep community through service while enhancing the experience of everyone at Flint Ridge Prep. Over four decades, no one has embodied the mission of the Flint Ridge Prep Fathers Club the way you have, as both a headmaster and a member.
Hi, Peter. Congratulations on your retirement. Thank you for 40 years of service.
We salute your 40 years of commitment to our children, your dedication to the families of Prep, and your vision of Prep for life. On behalf of the Fathers Club, we want to thank you for your friendship, for your leadership, and your mentorship. Congratulations on your retirement.
Peter, on behalf of the Parents Association, Prep parents across generations, and me personally, thank you for being an incredible leader for all of us. You've created a community that is so full of love, and it shows in every part of our lives here, from our dedicated parent volunteers to our children's experiences. Because of that, we know from the moment we walk onto campus, this is the place for our kids. You've been such a huge part of my own family's life these past 8 years, and long before that. It's hard to imagine Prep without you. Thank you so much, and congratulations on your retirement.
Thank you, Peter.
Thank you, Mr. Bachmann, from three generations of Jamesons.
Peter, from our family, we just want to say thank you for so much for being a colleague, a friend, a mentor, a great boss, a great leader.
Thank you for dozens and dozens of great and very intellectually stimulating conversations.
And thank you for being such a great teacher and such a great fosterer of learning through every interaction I've ever had with you.
We'll miss you.
Mr. Bachmann, thank you for incredible and thought-provoking Great Books discussions, for making time to support us at our sports events, music concerts, and more.
For always welcoming us back with a conversation and words of wisdom.
For taking the time to have a glass and a meal with us now and then.
For your visionary leadership, exemplary professionalism, and friendship.
May the road rise up to meet you.
May the wind be always at your back.
May the sun shine warm upon your face.
And the rains fall soft upon your fields. Until we meet again.
Thank you, Peter. Wishing you the best.
Happy retirement, Peter. Thank you for everything you've done.
Thank you, Mr. Bachmann.
Hey, Mr. Bachmann, I hope you're enjoying summer as much as your fellow class of 2020 alum. A couple years ago, I remember attending a prep open house and standing just outside of Norris before you were to speak with prospective students. Before you entered, however, you stopped to chat with me and ask how I was feeling about my classes, the football season, and the year so far. It was a small gesture, but an important one. Your willingness to take the time to check in with each member of the prep community made prep feel a little more like exactly that, a community. Your impact far exceeds that moment, but thank you for the countless small gestures.
Peter.
Good afternoon.
These tributes are only a few of the many fabulous testimonials we have received in honor of Peter. And you can see all the videos and dozens of the written testimonials on the Flint Ridge Prep tribute portal. I'm Rob Lewis. I'm a member of the faculty and a proud part of this community. And it is a pleasure to see you all here today. I interviewed for the drama faculty position on my 29th birthday. I woke up just before dawn, executed the world's worst face shave, donned a tie, grabbed my portfolio, and head up the hill to a town I had never even heard of. And just after getting off the freeway and mentally flagging the neighboring Ralph's and Trader Joe's as a plus, I arrived on that pathway to the front door, the little terracotta building, and I did my best. I was very mindful about standing up straight, even though I felt so small. And I opened the front door. And I'm looking at this pale green carpet and tufted leather couches, mahogany fireplace, portraiture, chandelier, and table lamps. And I must have stood there for quite a second until Karen Stamenson says, "Why don't you take a seat, honey?" Now, this is not just my story alone. Every teacher knows it. That day, that interview day, was a revolving door of interviews and classes and tours around campus, round and round, and until the very last stop, which is a plush cushioned chair inside Peter's office. And thinking about it right now as I'm turning 30, I remember, okay, maybe for the 14th time, I remember there's this great sense of everything just slowing down. There was something. It was as if Peter's office defied time. And there's Peter. And he welcomes me, and he asks me how my day was, and what did I see. And we talk, and he tells me what he's looking forward to for the school, and says if I'm the drama teacher, I get to make it my own. And before long, he shakes my hand and bids me farewell, and I close that front door behind me, and a new one opens up. Now, before I go any further, it must be noted that anybody who's been around Peter long enough has been graced with some aspect of his vision. You might not even be aware of the infinite ways he's impacted you, and we all know buildings have been erected, programs have grown, entire departments were born. Even the mission and the purpose of the school has within it Peter's undeniable signature. But I want to put that list to the side for a minute to highlight something small, a small gesture. On that day, that interview day, he asked me, "What do you see?" And this is not just about hearing observations, but in this brief candle-flickered moment, he's asking me about the potential of me. He's asking me and everyone before me and everyone after me who has sat in that very chair about our vision. You see, it's not just his vision alone. Every teacher has something magical to share. Every staff has a strength that they wield. Every parent has a wish for their child. And every student dreams about the future and a way to make the world a better place. People want to do something good with the time that is given to them. And a lot of this starts in this very chair. All of this, all of us live in Peter's eyes. He listens, he aligns the stars, and he charts a course. Time and again, I have found myself in that cushioned chair, sometimes to work out a budget, but more often as a colleague, Peter as my confidant, as my mentor, and my friend. And he puts everything else away, and he sees the individual in front of him. The faculty knows that Peter sees the whole person who creates the teaching and wants your heart and your expertise to illuminate that pathway for students to wonder, to inquire, to thrive. And of course he will challenge you. Of course he will encourage you to step up, to discover what actually is your potential. And he will move heaven and earth to keep you afloat, especially in those times when your everything flips upside down and your world seems to go dark. Peter will hold the light. These years pass, dancing and fumbling, and memories yarn almost tales too unbelievable to be true. And my time is comparably short. I can't even begin to fathom the vast history that Peter has encountered. And I tell you this right now, Peter remembers everything. But in my mediocre short time, I've seen Jody Hare do front handsprings across the gym floor and Dan tending bar at JPD like a champ. Joe Maggio running a faculty softball game with an iron fist, and Mike Mullins shredding the guitar on this very stage. I've seen Kim offer her stash of chocolate from her bookcase next to her desk, and Vachi's characteristic wink, and Kathy Haroon's laugh. I've watched Garrett and Alex huddled over a phone to check the latest scores. I've seen Bob Lockery descend those stairs every December, jolly and bright, while I've also seen John Rook hand out cynical hats. I've watched Midge watch her daughter Megan speak about her new book, and Sean get teary-eyed talking about Glenn. I've seen Cooper boys grow and, well, Oak boys by the league. And I've seen Reggie's children come to visit with grandchildren in tow. I have seen a community to decide to raise their children here with you. Year after year, I've seen colleagues become family, family become friends. And one by one, we've come through that front door, maybe a little bit smaller at the time, and Peter's welcomed us into this home, our home. On that birthday, Peter, you gave me a gift. But not just me, all of us. You've given us all the gift of seeing in each and every single one of us more than we ever knew or what we were ever capable of. What was possible. This marks a visionary. This is the mark of a leader. So, right here, right now, Peter, I need to properly answer your question. What do I see? I see an icon, the stuff of legends, a headmaster, a grandfather, a dean of students, a history teacher, a father, a husband, a graduate, a student with a gleam in his eye and hope in his heart that one day, with all his potential, he'll make the world a better place. And you have. You make us human beings realize life while we're still living it. Every minute of it. We commend you, Peter Bachmann, today and for always, on your exceptional headmastership and your teaching. Thank you for making our stories be a part of yours. Your story is prep for life. Now we pay tribute to Peter with the following video.
Several members of this senior class appeared in our 1989 production of Harvey. They may recall the comment of Elwood P. Dowd, the gentleman who went through life accompanied by an imaginary white rabbit. Mr. Dowd philosophized, "In this world, you must be oh so smart or oh so pleasant." For years, I was smart. I recommend pleasant. Well, we recommend both.
It's so hard to capture my relationship with Peter.
Faculty member.
My colleague.
Trusted advisor.
Counselor, confidant.
Who has the biggest heart.
He's also nice on the golf course.
Easy to talk to from the get-go.
I don't think there's a person he's talked to that he hasn't had a meaningful connection with.
He walks his talk in every way.
One of my life's heroes. He believed in me.
Seeing that light on in Peter's office means that we're home.
We just all stood up a little bit straighter when Mr. Bachmann walked by.
My first memory of Peter Bachmann was that fall of my seventh grade year when he got up in front of a full auditorium in Norris Auditorium and performed in a bucket of noodles. I remember thinking, this is someone who cares about students.
If my husband were a play, it would definitely be The Tempest with Pete as Prospero.
He knows everything that's going on, and he has a hand in everything, but you'd never notice it.
He creates storms that cause shipwrecks that bring people to his island, and then he provides experiences that help them grow.
He's the one doing the magic.
When Molly and I first drove out here, I thought we'd be here about 2 or 3 years.
I had assured my mother in North Carolina when we left that we would come back east. That was 40 years ago.
Growing up as teachers, we're just a nice, tight, snug little group. Our little Robbie running around the sideline of the football field. So our families grew up.
I never bought that there would be a moat between a personal life and a professional life.
The faculty is his family, it's my family, the students are his family. Much of them are my family as well.
We were so excited when Peter became headmaster because we knew that Pete had the same kind of values that we all had.
He has always very compellingly and very sincerely made it clear that the work of the faculty, the quality of the faculty is the school's greatest asset.
We're encouraged to constantly be collaborating with one another and to share our ideas.
I think it's really extraordinary that Peter meets with every member of the staff every year and has a really frank conversation.
I've tried to drive a truck through the unapproachable perception. I was always going to teach. I was always going to go to a lot of events. I was always going to try to have fun.
Something that I've been able to take into my own professional career has been his ability to identify what it is that people do best, allow them to do that every day, and then recognize them for it.
He brings teachers in and then gives them the running room and the trust to create their own version of that sacred space in the classroom.
Peter has the ability to pull things out of people they didn't even know were there.
If Peter were a period in history, he'd probably be a progressive era. As much as he likes tradition, he does like to see change done in a measured fashion.
In the early years, we were pursuing best practices. We wanted to do well by other people's standards. I think as we grew in institutional self-confidence, we sort of said, well, why can't we set the standard?
All these things that I think make us not only good professionals someday down the line, or college students even, but with good people.
He really brought that mentality to this school, the mentality that the day doesn't end when the bell rings.
We believe that human development is equal to intellectual development and are committed to pursuing both at the same time.
It's an incredible place for children to transition from being children to becoming young adults.
What gives Peter the greatest joy is, I think, teaching, bringing people along with an idea.
He was a headmaster who always taught.
He loved seeing light bulbs flash on in the minds of young people, and he loved to see where those kind of light bulbs would carry them later in life.
He believes in the idea that it's not just one teacher spoon-feeding knowledge to a classroom.
Just sort of a moderator and a guide instead of a lecturer.
My favorite moments in the classroom are when we're in flow, when No one knows if there's a clock in the room. When we are just into the text, into the conversation, and into one another.
My kids both said that Peter's class was the best class they had here at Prep.
He wanted to be in great books. You wanted him to come into your class, and when he did, you wanted to participate. You wanted to share your ideas with him.
I think it was in the second year that I developed the good life as the ultimate project and the final paper.
He started off the class. The very first thing he says is, what is the good life? Somehow, just the way he says it, something will click.
Initially, it was a foray into utopian literature, but then after that, it really became just our own personal exploration of ideals, and actually that was the first time we ever had to ask ourselves, what is it that we really want out of life?
This classroom, inside here, we're a community of whatever, you know, 16, 17, with a shared goal and shared trust. Peter understood that the way to move a community is by creating shared bonds and by creating a communal vision.
We're focused on doing what's best for the community.
Seniors and seventh graders are passing each other and they know each other and they say hello, and many kids will talk about the seniors they knew when they were younger.
We're not rooting for other students to do poorly because that will make us look better. We're all working together towards a common goal. It all comes from Peter.
He doesn't look at you like you're a student or you're a faculty or you're a parent. He looks at each person for who they are and how he can relate to them.
This is a school with a heart. That's the difference. It's academically incredible, but the compassion and care for the student, who they are as human beings, that's because of Peter Bachmann.
That's so central to the DNA of Flint Ridge Prep now, the sense that people come first and relationships come first.
Honesty, generosity, kindness, respect have become internalized because of their use, because of ritual.
He would do things to bring the community together.
The family barbecue.
Book days.
The mock trial.
Honor code signing ceremony. A junior parent dinner. Santa party. Senior trip. Schools offer symbolic structure and meaning to people's lives with their rituals.
He'll show up at games and performances and events. This is a man who wants to stay connected.
Rather than fame, rather than riches, rather than honor, give me truth. And so I ask students to erase the word truth and substitute their own. Give you what? Is your word truth? Is it fame? Is it riches? Is it honors? Is it love? What's your one non-negotiable that you start with? My non-negotiable is love. And I love Flint Ridge Prep.
My graduation was only the beginning of a new relationship with Flint Ridge Prep.
Prep for life means families.
It wouldn't be a speech if I didn't talk about our son, Rob. He's become kind of a metaphor for the whole prep experience.
My son's graduation was maybe the single biggest highlight of my time at Prep.
You know, how he navigated being the son of a head is, I think, an interesting question.
The first couple years were a little tough, you know, with my middle school year, which is tough to begin with.
I remember when he would have me drop him off a block away from a middle school dance.
The magic of Prep is the way the faculty impacts the kids, the cumulative effect of that over time. We definitely saw that in Rob's growth and development.
By the 11th and 12th grade, when he began to mature, when I began to teach his friends, when I actually would lecture in classes that he was a member of, it became a huge bond between us.
He's fostered in me and others a willingness to take chances and to explore.
That shared knowledge of Prep and experience was very important to Rob and to Pete.
One of the truly unsung heroes, I think, is Molly.
I call her the first mom.
I think she was a nice compliment to my dad in style and temperament.
Generous, you know, with her time, advice, and also just willingness to build and maintain community.
When I was offered the job in 1991, the chair said to me, we decided on Molly 6 months ago. We had to figure out whether we wanted you.
Peter meets challenges by being the embodiment or this balance of head and heart.
He always believes there's good. He always believes that the situation can be better, that we can heal, that we can grow.
We've dealt with a whole array of things. We're not just talking about human values here in our school. We're talking about how we've held a school together.
I would really like to thank the teachers who have been leading us in all our online education and the tech and administrative and staff that have all supported those efforts. Mostly though, I'd like to thank you students. Even though this is a complicated time with some disappointments, that you're making the most out of it.
There is a future of this school, and it will be great, but as someone who was a student here, it is really hard to imagine this place without him.
I think as he exits, that collaboration building speaks volumes. It's a statement of student engagement. He's lived a life of engagement.
His legacy will be in, you know, the hearts and minds and the relationships that exist on campus.
He's built this really robust community that I think will continue to be prep because he built it so well.
At the end of the Tempest, Prospero, who has had magical powers, is deciding to renounce his magic. My advice for Pete moving forward is don't renounce your magic.
Peter, here we go. You're gonna start your next adventure.
Thank you for mentoring me.
Believing in me from our first interview.
Bringing me to the school that I love so much.
You've given me so many opportunities to be my best.
Opportunities that you have given me, the opportunities you've given to my kids.
Your willingness to teach me as a student and as a teacher myself.
Your guidance, your headship.
What you did for me as a student and what you've done for me as a parent.
For everything that you've given to me and my family.
All the amazing times we've had.
Thank you so much for the 40 years of making me a better person.
The incredible decades, and be picky about your next adventures
because I know there will be many.
It has been the greatest joy of our life to be able to be involved at prep.
I feel so much better for having been at this school and feel ready for college just because of all the things that you've given me.
Thank you for bringing me to your island.
Thank you.
To quote your favorite work in all literature.
Our revels now are ended. And these are actors, as I foretold you, who are all spirits and are melted into air, into thin air. And, like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the solemn temples, the great globe itself shall dissolve and, like this insubstantial pageant faded, leave not a rack behind. We are such stuff as dreams are made on. And our little life is rounded in a sleep.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor and esteemed privilege to present our headmaster, Mr. Peter Bachmann.
So many people to thank for this event. The participants here today, David Cottiga, Chris Leslie from the board, my fellow 2020 graduate and colleague and friend, Rob Lewis, my student, friend, and now boss, Katie Thompson, and all who've contributed to this video and the many videos and the many notes and remembrances that are coming in. To Nicole Trevor and Mel Malberg and Lakshmi Duster Johnson, the entire external affairs team. to everyone who's come to join us today, all my old friends, and to our very special guests, the newest residents of La Cañada, the Pickett family. I'm deeply honored. A few years ago, I was sitting around with John Rook and Alex Rivera and Glenn Beatty after golf, and with Brady Locke, a friend and colleague from our first years who was back in town for a niece's prep graduation. Brady looked at us and said, "Do you realize how unusual this is, how lucky you are? 35 years together?" And of course he was right. We're all lucky. And how lucky am I to be doing what I love, in a place that I love, among people I love for virtually my entire adult life. I've had colleagues, including these veterans and the faculty and staff, to the newest teachers who each day make me laugh and think and feel their warmth. I've had the support of over 100 trustees who, in the words of one, have tenderly offered me counsel and wisdom. And I've known thousands of students and gotten to watch them grow and go through life, and sometimes even have gotten to teach their children. And they continue to teach me. A few of you grads from the 80s are looking a little older. But just remember, what you lose in youth, you pick up in wisdom and gravitas. And remember also, I will always be older than you. Molly and I are lucky to be parents of an alum and to remain part of the class of 2003 and part of parents of alum friendships throughout the years. And our most recent graduates, my classmates of 2020, have made us proud with their resilience through this tumultuous spring. We've all been planning for this moment for 6 years, but you can never plan for the depth of emotion of gratitude. On Father's Day, last Sunday, my son Rob, a new father, so this was our first Father's Day as fathers together, we're musing about the key decisions we'd made in our life and the differences that they had made. The key decision I described was in December 1979, when I came to have two interviews at two schools in one day. I liked the first school a lot, deeply respected it, was very excited by it, and I thought it would be impossible to beat. Until I walked down that path, through that door, into that living room, which Rob, I do believe, certainly had the same portrait of Doan Lowry, our founder, had the same couch. Thank goodness the rest of it, I think, has been revamped by Tyke O'Brien, but it's still the same living room. And I sat by that fireplace, and I walked on that campus and met people with smiling faces. My head told me to go with the first school. My heart told me to go with the second. And my heart's been proven right for 40 years. And counting. Thanks to all of you who continue to prove my heart right. And now I would like to introduce one of the people I respect most in the world, who at this stage considers herself one of the world's biggest suckers. Chris Leslie became a prep parent in 2005. In 2008, I asked her to join the Board of Trustees. In 2010, I asked her to become the vice chair and eventual chair of the board. In 2011, I asked her to co-chair our capital campaign. And in 2014, after she completed her first round as chair, I gave her a week off, well, 3 to 5 days off, and asked her to please join our newly formed head transition team. In 2016, I asked her to return to the board. And in 2018, I asked her to become vice chair, chair of the head search committee, and eventual chair again, which she will become on Wednesday. Her husband, Reed, is wearing a mask, but I know what he's thinking as I recount these events. But he carefully does mask his annoyance and his fear that I'm going to ask her to do something else. But I'm not. I'm just going to thank her. Please welcome our chair-elect, Chris Leslie.
Thank you, Peter. And I think the lesson there is apparently I cannot say no to Peter Bachmann. So. In a few minutes, David, Kadaga, and I are going to share something from the entire Board of Trustees that reflects on Peter's time at PrEP. But before I do that, I wanted to just take a couple of minutes and share some personal reflections about Peter. So in addition to being the parent of 3 PrEP graduates, as Peter mentioned, I've been a trustee for 10 years, serving as the board chair back in 2012. And as a trustee, and in particular when you become the chair, one of the great gifts you receive is getting to know Peter on a much more personal level. Working closely over the course of that decade, I've seen Peter celebrate a lot of success and achievement, and I've also seen him handle very difficult and challenging issues. And I'd like to share with you what I've learned. Peter is one of the most humble people I know. What he has accomplished at PrEP over the past 40 years is truly extraordinary, but he would never say it, hint at it, or even imply it. As Katie mentioned in her talk, Peter is incredibly generous. Generous with his time, with his treasure, with his talents, and most of all, with his heart. Peter approaches every situation with deep caring and empathy. Peter is a deeply devoted person. To his family, to his friends, to his colleagues, and to the students at Flint Ridge Prep. Peter is somebody you know you can trust. And finally, his impeccable integrity guides his every action, interaction, and decision. Simply said, Peter Bachmann lives the Flint Ridge Prep Honor Code every day. These are the qualities that are woven into the fabric of Flint Ridge Prep. These are the qualities that make the faculty and staff feel valued and supported. And while Peter won't be walking the campus every day going forward, these are the qualities that have created and will ensure that PrEP is always a place where adolescents can come and flourish as they prepare for their engaged, balanced, and responsible life. It has certainly been an honor to serve as a trustee with Peter, but in truth, the real honor that I cherish is calling him my dear friend. Thank you, Peter, and congratulations. At our final meeting of the school year and Peter's final meeting as headmaster, the Board of Trustees presented Peter with a resolution recognizing his extraordinary lifelong service to Flint Ridge Prep. I believe you will all agree that this truly captures the breadth of Peter's impact over the past 4 decades. Whereas Mr. Peter Bachmann, from the moment he stepped on campus in the fall of 1980 through his installation as headmaster in 1991 up to and including the present moment, has exhibited the most thorough dedication and love for Flint Ridge Preparatory School. Whereas Headmaster Bachmann's vision for placing human development at the core of the school resulted in a community universally acknowledged to be honest, kind, generous, and respectful, graduating engaged young adults who are prepared to live a good life and who believe in the prep for life ethos. Whereas thanks to his judicious stewardship, Headmaster Bachmann exponentially increased the school's endowment during his tenure from $1 million to an excess of $33 million, ensuring Flint Ridge Prep will continue to thrive for years to come. Whereas during his tenure, Headmaster Bachmann secured significant gifts from foundations, alumni, parents, and friends, including most recently in the Enrich, Inspire, Ignite campaign, which raised in excess of $38 million, thereby enabling the school to develop a world-class faculty, a beautiful Sylvan campus environment, state-of-the-art learning facilities, an excellent financial aid program, and superb curricular programming. Whereas Headmaster Bachmann teaches with spirit, imagination, rigor, and verve, is a constant intellectual seeker, a deep reader, profound thinker, inspired writer, and is a treasured mentor to students and alumni. Whereas his example is emulated by his beloved faculty colleagues, whom he supports unstintingly, with whom he fosters throughout the entire community, human and intellectual development, a devotion to balance, and a lifelong love for learning. Whereas under the leadership of Headmaster Bachmann, Flint Ridge Prep has enjoyed a steadily rising academic reputation, as evidenced by increasing application rates, a high admissions yield, and buoyant rankings both locally and nationally, enrolling and graduating students of the highest achievement. Whereas in countless articles and speeches, and as the author of Advancing Confidently and Standing on Shoulders, Headmaster Bachmann has passionately and persuasively championed the value of a liberal arts education, engaged teaching, creative critical thinking, and the development of the whole person as fundamental to a life well lived. Whereas through enthusiastic, wholehearted participation in countless school events on and off campus, from sports to arts to dinners to alumni weddings, Headmaster Bachmann's genuine warmth and interest, his unfailing and prodigious memory, and his evident love of his own life well lived have touched and inspired generations of faculty, alumni, students, and parents.
It's so long, it takes two of us to read this. Whereas in 2019, as the Atrium Project was completed, Peter Bachmann announced his retirement on June 30th, 2020. Whereas in February 2019, the Board of Trustees of Flint Ridge Preparatory School named the newest campus project the Bachmann Collaboration Building in honor of and in tribute to Headmaster Bachmann's extraordinary vision and commitment to the school over 40 years, including his work with students, faculty, alumni, the board, the staff, the whole community. Whereas in response to the 2020 worldwide pandemic and the shift to remote learning, Headmaster Bachmann has shown extraordinarily steady leadership, empathy, strength, and grace, supporting everyone on his broad shoulders and inviting us to lean on one another, to continue to embrace our community of learning and growth, and to share Walden moments. Whereas in recognition of this and so much more over four decades, Headmaster Bachmann has been the recipient of not one, but two Class of 1987 awards and countless personal and public tributes. Whereas Headmaster Bachmann, over 40 years of selfless service, authentically hewed to and lived out his goals for the school he set forth at his installation in 1991, to wit, civility, growth, communication, enthusiasm, and empathy. Whereas Headmaster Bachmann has set the stage for, encouraged, and modeled the Prep for Life ethos with his engaged, responsible devotion, his genuine curiosity and reverence for learning, and his deep and enduring love for the community he built. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the Board of Trustees of Flint Ridge Preparatory School declares its deepest appreciation to Peter Bachmann, extends its best wishes for his next adventures in learning and in life, and confers upon Peter Bachmann the title of Headmaster Emeritus as of July 1, 2020. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be entered permanently into the minutes of the Flint Ridge Preparatory School Board of Trustees, signed on this day, May 28, 2020, on the occasion of his final meeting with the Board of Trustees as headmaster, signed by David Cottiga, Chair, and Chris Leslie, Vice Chair. In February of 2019, when the board contemplated how to honor Peter's 40-year legacy, the answer to us was simple: just honor his vision. At that time, the board unanimously voted to name the building the Bachmann Collaboration Building. This afternoon, we are unveiling a special plaque designed by faculty members Ricardo Rodriguez and Melissa Manful. This plaque, a smaller replica of which will be given to Peter today, will be permanently mounted on the Bachmann Building. It will be a reminder to all of us that the light was always on in Peter's office, that we always had his support, and that promise and progress are within our reach. At this time, let's take a moment and thank our headmaster with our applause, especially those of you out there on Zoom. Thank you. Thank you very much. Peter, it's my duty to just remind everybody that the Bachmann Collaboration Building is not only on schedule and on budget, and we are planning to open it in time for the start of the new school year. And finally, it's my pleasure to introduce a special tribute with lyrics by recent graduate Ryan Waldheim, class of 2020. Ryan is the son of alumnus Chris Waldheim, class of 1985. Please enjoy.
Light up our day. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, hey, hey. is to you, Mr. Bachmann. Rebels love you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mr. Bachmann. History, great books light up our day. Studying his history with all the Berkeley Bears. East for work, he'll soon be walking down the aisle. And cheers to you, Mr. Bachmann. Rebels love you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. God bless you, please, Mr. Bachmann. History, great books light up our day. September afternoon, going to some school in La Cañada. History to Dean of Students, now Prep's headmaster. His legacy lasts ever after. Farewell to you, Mr. Bachmann. Rebels love you more than you will know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Love you, Mr. Bachmann. 40 years we celebrate today. Prep for life. Prep for life. We love you, Mr. Bachmann.